friends, welcome to this weekly updates on Indian manufacturing sector. My name is Anand and I am your trusted lean manufacturing implementation partner. Now let us start with today's important updates. First, let us talk about automotive sector. Jaguar Land Rover is developing a cabin air purification technology to inhibit viruses and bacteria. This particular technology can cut the viruses and bacteria by up to 97%. They are actually using Panasonic's technology to inhibit harmful bacteria and viruses, and that will keep the cabins of the cars nice condition so that it can prevent the diseases also. In fact, they are also partnering with biomedical laboratory called Perfectus Biomed Limited, partnership between these three companies, Jaguar, then Panasonic, as well as this Perfectus Biomed Limited. The next news is from automotive sector. Indian government is planning to deregister passenger vehicles which are more than 20 years old. And this will happen from June 2024. The government is also planning to deregister commercial vehicles which are more than 15 years. This will happen from April 1, 2023. And the government is also making it mandatory to obtain fitness certificates for personal vehicles. And they want to focus on the top 10 polluting cities in India. According to some estimates, more than 51 lakh light motor vehicles in the country which are more than 20 years old, and 34 lakh motor vehicles which are more than 15 years old. There will be about 17 lakh medium and heavy vehicles which are more than 15 years old. So when we deregister all these vehicles, this vehicle has to be scrapped. So the scrapping industry, that will become a 7.2 lakh crore industry, and it will bring in a lot of investments which are up to about 10,000 crores, and it will create about 35,000 jobs in the country. Right? Currently, the scrapping industry is completely unorganized, and in the future, this will become like an organized industry. According to Mercedes-Benz, the high taxes on luxury vehicles in India, they are restricting the growth of this particular sector. They say that the high tax on luxury vehicles are restricting the growth. And despite being a small base, if you look at the luxury car market in India, it will be less than 5%. Industry estimates showed that more than 21,000 luxury cars were sold in the local market last year. This is compared to about 34,000 vehicles in the previous year. So the market shrunk, and now it is looking for growth. So, according to Mercedes-Benz, the high taxes are restricting the growth. E-vehicle manufacturer called Strom Motors, they have received bookings worth ₹7.5 crore for their R3 model. It's a car company, electric car manufacturer, a new company in India. And they have received bookings for about 165 units of cars, which are like revenue of about ₹7.5 crores. Their cars are going to be priced at 4.5 lakh. This is founded in 2016 by Mr. Pratik Gupta and Jean-Luc Abbasio. And they have opened the booking in the last week only, and immediately they got about 165 orders. This particular car, Strom R3, is a two-seater car, and it's an ARAI certified vehicle. It has a top range of about 200 km. So let us see how these new electric vehicles are performing in the market. And Indian passenger vehicle industry, that is set to grow by about 22-25% in the financial year 22, according to ICRA. There's a degrowth which happened in the last year, but now after the COVID lockdowns and now the economy is picking up, so ICRA is projecting that there will be a growth of about 22-25%. There is also another reason that people are started preferring private vehicles instead of using public transport, so that also will fuel the growth in the near future. And again, coming to government regulations, India will not extend the 2022 deadline for creating tighter norms for fuel efficient vehicles. Industry was actually looking at or waiting for the government to reduce these norms a little bit. The corporate average fuel efficiency CAFE requirements are designed to reduce the carbon emissions from vehicles in India, and it pushes the automotive manufacturers to invest more into fuel efficient cars and bikes in a cleaner technology like electric or hybrid technology. We are looking at 103 grams per kilometer fuel efficient technology mode. But let us see, still there is one or two more years. We'll see how the industry comes up with their solution for this. Next, we'll move on to auto ancillary sector. When we look at auto sector growing at 22 or 25%, automotive sector also will grow in the same rate so that they can meet the demand from the auto industries. This automotive component sector also will rebound by about 21 to 23%. This particular data is provided by CRISIL. They have spoken to about 230 top auto ancillary components company, which they contribute about 40% of the overall industry, automotive component sector. And they have said that this year they will grow by about 21 to 23%. Sona Comstar commissions a new manufacturing plant at Manesar. Sona BLW Precision Forging, Sona, a part of Sona Group, they have started a new operation in Manesar, Haryana. This particular facility is spread across 5 acres and they produce differential assemblies and e-drive modules for companies' global customers. The plant is expected to generate direct employment of about 720 skilled workers, and they have allocated about 370 crore for the facility. Some of the investment has already started and the rest would be done in the next few years. Tire manufacturing company JK Tires, they have partnered with JBM Automotive to create smart radial tires. These smart tires will provide real-time information about the health of the tires to the users. And JK Tire and JBM have tied up for this particular new technology, and their tires are also providing optimum durability and performance. That's what they claim. Next, we move on to electronics segment. Samsung is applying for about 12,000 crore telecom gear PLI scheme. PLI scheme is production linked incentive scheme, which is driven by the government of India. The idea is to make 4G and 5G gear for telecom industry. As of now, Samsung is only working with Reliance Jio besides some global clients, but in the future they will be working with more telecom companies. That's the plan. Mobile phone manufacturer Xiaomi, they pledged about 100 crore to increase retail reach and also generate jobs for more than 10,000 people. They are planning to invest about 100 crore for this particular expansion. And the idea is to create more retail shops or stores, MI stores. Currently it is about 3,000 stores, and they are planning to reach 6,000 stores in the next 2 years. And this means additional 10,000 people will get more employment. NXP India, they launched a semiconductor incubation and acceleration program in association with the MeITY and FabCI. MeITY is Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology, and FabCI is a fabless chip design incubator company. I mean, it's sponsored by IIT Hyderabad. So NXP India is one of the biggest R&D centers, and NXP semiconductors, they announced this collaboration with IIT Hyderabad and also MeITY, Ministry for Electronics and Information Technology. The next decade is all about creating a world that anticipates and automates. That's what they quoted, with a lot of smart devices, connected systems, artificial intelligence. And this particular incubation program is helpful. It will create a lot of technology around that space. Continuing the growth story, home appliances and smartphone sales, they are all continue to increase. The post lockdown, there is a big surge of purchase of home appliances and smartphones. January to March quarter, there was a lot of brands which saw double digit growth. And but there are some fears for the upcoming quarter also, because the second wave of COVID is spreading fast, and there are some states which are going for a partial lockdown, etc. So there is a little bit of fear is there, but overall the industry looks positive. That's what we can understand from the sector. White good companies like LG, Bosch, Siemens, Voltas, Panasonic, Lloyd, Godrej, everybody, they have posted up to 40% increase in the sales, which is very good. But let us wait and watch for the next quarter also. Johnson Controls and Hitachi, they look for 20% growth in 2022, and they also plan to reduce their dependence on imports by 50%. We all know that Hitachi air conditioners, Johnson Controls, they are one of the premium air conditioning companies in India, and they are looking to grow by more than 20% this year. The reason for this increase in AC sales may be due to the increase in work from home category of people. Yeah? So there is a lot of demand from work from home, so more people are buying ACs. Let us look at some of the other sectors. AEPC, Apparel Export and Promotion Council, they have urged the cotton mill owners to cut the yarn prices by rupees 20 per kg. This is primarily due to, you know, the overall price of cotton has reduced, right? AIPC chairman Mr. Shaktivel, he has requested the Cotton Corporation of India to reduce the cotton prices by about 20 rupees per kg, because current price is about 1500 per candy. He requested the mill owners to bring down the yarn price by rupees 20 per kg with immediate effect. The last two months, the global cotton prices have come down by rupees 2500. So overall there is a price decrease. So what AIPC is asking is the mill owners to reduce the yarn prices also. These are all some of the interesting news from the manufacturing sector over the last 2-3 weeks. If you like this particular video, please give your thumbs up, and you can also subscribe to our channel. You can also share it with your friends and connections so that they will also learn about what's happening in the industry. I'll talk to you in the next week. See you. Thank you very much.